Okay, fine. See, the intention behind this orientation, you know, one person to thank is your friend, because she was behind me to start a separate batch for all of you. Today's orientation, I'll just tell you how to prepare and what I have planned for you all. So I have already taken your official calendar. I have identified your holidays. I have planned everything for you according to your holidays so that you don't have to take any extra leave. But just in case the notification comes and we don't have time, then I might ask you all to take a leave. But otherwise, what I planned will not require any leave. As far as June vara kaithe, we don't require. The batch idea is from 23rd January. I'll share the dates with you all shortly, to 19th June, including Saturdays and Sundays. I am getting, and your holidays, I am getting 50 days, okay? And 50 days is good enough for me to comprehensively cover, because I don't have to do from the basic for some subjects. For some subjects, I have to do from the basic. Now, when I take you through each area, I'll tell you where you require from the basic, where it is not required. Okay, 50 days into 8 hours a day. 8 hours, we can stretch beyond 8, but let's put it at 8 hours. Okay, 400 hours is what I will get with you all for your mains. But apart from this, the reason why I put it only till 19th June is, even if we have to stretch a little, we will have 3-4 days extra in June in case something happens and you are not able to take a class in between. I will have that cushion. So please prepare yourself till June end for this batch. Okay. Now this is what these are the dates I have planned in 8 hours a day. I have already spoken to the team. Everybody is ready. How we want to do this is, you know, we are not going to get into any dictation in class. What we are going to teach in the next week will be told to you beforehand, so that you have those 4-5 days to read up and come to the class. Whatever information has to be given will be given in handout. Every topic will be explained and questions will be discussed with the structure. No ready-made questions will be given and tests will be conducted for every paper. This is what we planned. Okay. Now let me begin with first the areas and where you need to put extra effort. How do we take your knowledge of MCQs into answer writing? Let me tell you the challenges, areas where you have to focus more, which areas will be the deciding areas for your exam. Now, as you all know, paper 1 is general essay. Okay? Request you all to listen. I will give you time to write. First, listen, please. General essay, as you know, is for 150 marks, and if you have seen the syllabus, there are 6 areas that are identified in your syllabus for general essay. What are the 6 areas? One area is history and culture. Okay. The second area is politics, and it says dynamics in Indian politics. So it is going to be current based. The third area is economic development. Okay, the fourth area talks about the social problems in India. Society, social problems in India. The fifth area is developments in science and technology. Okay, and the last area is human resources and education. These are the 6 areas that have been given in your syllabus. From my perspective, usually what students do is they are in a hurry to prepare for general essay, because it is 150 marks. Scoring here is very easy for the simple reason that, you know, you need to write only 3 essays. You'll have ample time to write those 3 essays and it is easier. You have wider choice here. From my perspective, this area should be prepared, this paper should be studied at the end of each subject. Now, why am I saying this? Do you think it makes any sense in preparing for history and culture without first completing history and culture? And here, I will also include I won't be surprised if there is an essay on the last phase of the agitation, if there is an essay on 1969 agitation. So, you know, unless we complete these areas, I will not ask you to write essays on this part, because for essay you need content, and content comes from your remaining 5 papers. So here what we do is, we first finish a particular area, and that teacher will deal with that particular area's essays. One teacher will not deal with essays, because, you know, whoever, for example, I take Telangana movement, I have to tell you the essays in Telangana movement. Somebody else cannot do it for you. Okay, likewise, unless I finish polity and governance, I will not be able to do essays on politics. You know, there are certain essays. Usually, I divide essays into two. One will be static. One will be dynamic. You know, there are evergreen essays like electoral reforms, freedom of press. Then there will be some specific essays which will be related only at that point of time. Okay, so we have to identify the static part, dynamic part. For every area, we should do it. This will be by and large static, but here it will be dynamic. Economic development law, you should complete economy. You should complete, you have development and environment problems in your syllabus. In group 2, it was development and change and developmental problems. Unless we complete this, we will not be able to do essays on this. Okay, for this, we have to complete society and social structure. And here also you have some evergreen areas. One thing that will always be asked is, it could be women empowerment, it could be a specific problem, increasing abuse, effect of COVID on the status of women in India, all these can be asked in social problems. Tarvata, development in science and technology, this we will not be able to do unless we do the science and tech part in your syllabus. Okay, and this is an area which overlaps with economy, which overlaps with society. If you have seen your society syllabus, there is a full unit, one full chapter on various schemes related to the government with respect to human resources and education. So this area overlaps with economy and society. The best approach to general essays, please finish that respective subject and then start writing essays. That is what we plan to do. I will be identifying 40 topics which will include both static and dynamic areas for you for essay writing. Okay, and I'll ensure that you at least have 5 sample essays. See, I don't believe in dictating answers in class, because I should only be giving the structure, you should be writing the answer. So 5 sample essays will be good enough for you to understand how it should be written. But ultimately, you have to write, and the teacher will help you to write the essay. This is the first paper. Please make a note of this. Now, this is about general essay. And Deeniki, if you want to read, the only book I would suggest is Yojana and Kurukshetra, especially for the last one. Adidappa, there is no one book that you can refer for essays. Yojana would be good. And Kunni areas have to also talk about international affairs. Like here, IR is important, because you have to know the developments worldwide. Here, IR is important. Various conventions and all you should be knowing, because they should be mentioned. Okay, apart from that, you are not going to read IR in detail. Over. Now let's look at the second paper. I'll tell you what exactly will be different for you for group 2 and group 1 and paper 2, because you've read these areas in group 2 as well. Now, paper 2, as we know, has two areas. First, let me tell you one thing. Earlier, what happened is, before, you know, integrated APLO, we had three areas. Each area essentially had a weightage of 50 marks. Five questions would come, and they used to strictly stick to the unit. You know, from one, each unit, you would get one question. And in my group 2 exam, they totally went off the track with that. Telangana history itself, which was only two units, was given for more than 40-50 marks. Society, which was for 50 marks, it was reduced. So, you know, here I will not be able to tell you whether they'll stick to one unit, one question or not, which means that you should prepare everything, and everything is important for you. Okay. Now, in this paper, we will have Indian history. And culture would be one area. The second area would be history and culture. And third area is Indian and Telangana geography. Okay. Out of these three areas, the one which you have to focus more would undoubtedly be this area. The reason why I am telling you that this area should be focused more is, this area you did not study till now in detail. You only studied for roughly 20 marks. That was also mostly focused on facts. But here, that is not the case. Here it is going to be totally 1 minute. Okay, now 20 marks, it is mostly facts. India and Telangana geography here will not be factual. Okay, settle down first, then I'll talk. Okay, now finished? Please listen now. Here, India and Telangana geography, if you look at the whole syllabus, you'll notice that first and second units are conceptual. All your concepts are covered in one and two units. It also includes Indian geography. Okay, 3, 4, 5 are basically Telangana, and by and large this is factual. So you'll need to mug up a lot of things for 3, 4, 5. For this area, we will provide the handouts when we are teaching also. Focus will be more on this area because this is more conceptual. For this, whatever has to be read will be explained and the handouts will be given. Okay. Now, coming to this part, both these areas, the focus is more on modern history and socio-cultural history. Here also it is more on, because you, out of this, almost two units are only on Indian Renaissance. Okay, so socio-cultural history is focused more. And I'll tell you one more thing, this overlaps with your society, because in society also you're going to read women's movements, peasant movements and all that. Okay, now here 1 and 2 is ancient and medieval history. 3, 4, 5 is modern. And in this also, the entire 4th unit is related to socio-cultural movements in Telangana. Okay, modern period. Now, Indian history also, the situation is same. As I said, 1 and 2 will be ancient and medieval. 3, 4 and 5 are modern. Again, almost 4 and 3, you know, 3, 4, 5, 4 complete is related to socio-religious movements. In fact, they have given people like Jyotibai Phule and all that, and they've asked you to know about those people. So, you know, vala meeda manam 10 marks rasanthi information undali. Analysis are like what the direct questions are. Questions etla adugutar manam em practice cheyalanu nen last cheptar. So this is the overview of paper 2. Paper 2 lo meeri padu varaku em chestunnante, you also studied the same thing, but you have emphasized more on facts and you gave equal importance to ancient, medieval and modern. But now what we are going to do is, we are going to read modern more. We are going to emphasize more on socio-cultural history rather than the political part. Political part is necessary, but that is not complete. We need more of socio-cultural history. Make a note of this, please. This area is going to be deciding for you guys. I'll tell you where to focus more. In paper load, this is going to be very important because this is new. It is new for everybody and it's not easy to get the information that is given in 3, 4, 5 units. Finished? Moving on to the next. This is completely my paper. I am going to handle this. In fact, there will be a few areas in Indian history where I am going to handle the personalities and all, because it is related to movements. I would be handling them in all likelihood. Now, paper 3 again has 3 areas, but as I said, I will not be able to really tell you how the mark distribution is going to be. However, you can, polity and constitution is the first area. The second is governance. In the name of governance, they covered everything including ethics. The third is society and social structure. Okay. Now this you have already studied in your group 2. Did you read this? We did all this in group 2. How is it different from group 1? 70% of the syllabus is similar to group 2. Kani, here is a catch. Here you will be able to, you will get more of, there is a scope for analytical, more of analytical questions. Okay. And the rest of the topics, there are a few topics which are altogether like, linguism was not there in your group 2. Here it is there in the name of language. Okay. Rural, urban, continuum is mentioned in your syllabus. Casteism was there, but caste conflicts were not there earlier in group 2. So, you know, these are new areas. You will have about 8 to 9 areas which are totally new. And there is a special focus on Telangana. Telangana related problems, there is a special focus. So, this is society. I am going to focus more on the analysis part here. For everything, we are going to discuss cause, consequence, measures, way out is very important. And then they'll ask you, what is the way out? What is the solution? You should be able to give a solution. And solution will always come from the causes. Unless you know the problem, how will you find a solution for it? So we are going to approach it from that perspective. Ikkada kuda data chala important. Senses related data will play a very important role, especially the development related data. IMR diskonde, MMR diskonde, literacy rate, child sex ratio, sex ratio. This data will be very important for society. Now moving on to polity. Polity, the subject as such for you in group 2 was more about facts, was more about knowing the case laws. You remember in your group 2 also there were nearly 10 questions only on case laws. So you know, it was more about facts, it was more about case laws and direct questions. ఇక్కడికి వచ్చేసరికి ఏమవుతుందంటే, ఇట్ ఈస్ అబౌట్ లింకింగ్ కాన్సెప్ట్స్. ఓకే, సో యు నో దిస్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి టోటలీ అనలిటికల్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ క్వశ్చన్స్ లైక్ వి టాక్ అబౌట్ బ్యాలెన్స్ ఆఫ్ పవర్స్ ఇన్ ఇండియన్ కాన్స్టిట్యూషన్. హౌ డు వి సే దట్ దెర్ ఇస్ అ బ్యాలెన్స్ ఆఫ్ పవర్స్ అండ్ వై నాట్ సెపరేషన్ ఆఫ్ powers. Okay, what has the 42nd Constitutional Amendment Act done to the Constitution? How did it make irreversible changes to the Constitution? Okay, we say that the Constitution is rigid and flexible, but we have undergone 104 constitutional amendments. So is it really rigid or is it really flexible? How do you justify all these things? Okay, so here we are going to focus more on linking different concepts and a complete overview unte gaani manam answer cheyalem. And one special thing that I'm going to focus here on is recent Supreme Court judgments. I will not be surprised if there is a question on right to privacy. I will not be surprised if there is a question on religion, traditions, customs versus fundamental rights. Endukante triple talaq ఇవన్నీ దానికి సంబంధించినవి, శబరిమల. సో యు నో లాస్ట్ 4-5 ఇయర్ జడ్జ్మెంట్స్ ఐ ఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు పిక్ అప్ అండ్ మేక్ సమ్ క్వశ్చన్స్. మార్క్ మై వర్డ్స్, యుల్ గెట్ అట్లీస్ట్ 1 క్వశ్చన్ ఓన్లీ ఆన్ జడ్జ్మెంట్స్. దిస్ ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫర్ యూ. ఓకే, గవర్నెన్స్ అకార్డింగ్ టు మీ ఇస్ బేసికలీ అన్ ఎక్స్టెన్షన్ ఆఫ్ పాలిటీ, బికాస్ యు నో ఎవ్రీథింగ్ విల్ బి బేస్డ్ ఆన్ యువర్ కాన్స్టిట్యూషన్. ఇక్కడ గవర్నెన్స్ సిలబస్ లో దే హ్యావ్ ఇన్క్లూడెడ్ అ లాట్ ఆఫ్ థింగ్స్. Not just governance, they've also included constitutional and non-constitutional bodies. They have included some important legislations, laws like they have included ethics. They have included part of those topics which are actually given in civils under society. Under this, like NGOs, you know, development related organizations. This area is going to be new to you because majority of it was not there in group 2. In group 2 lo utti constitutional bodies koncham variki factual information varike chadvaru, and ikkada you have to understand how they are contributing, what are the loopholes and what measures can we suggest to improve their working. This will be focused more. Okay, so in this paper, this is important, this is going to be challenging because this is different from what you've studied in group 2. The next area will be this, because here there is a lot of scope for analysis. Please make a note of this. In this area, I'm going to spend more time on governance and society. Polity, mir already chaduvunnaru kabatti, polity I'm only going to discuss questions. Wherever concepts are essential, like judicial activism, I'm sure you must not have done anything on judicial activism. Atlanti matram in detail explain chestha. And these two areas we are going to focus more.
Now paper 4, according to me, this is the paper which has the maximum facts because it is Indian economy, Telangana economy and environmental problems. Now, please remember this area you actually studied as development and change in group 2. Okay. But here again, you know, in these three areas, I will say this is an area where you have a lot of scope for analytical questions. Okay, and please remember this area for some topics overlaps with society. For example, there is a topic called environmental degradation. Do you think environmental degradation also comes here? It also comes here. Kakapothe society lo, when you write about it, you have to talk about the impact on society. Here we talk more about the process, the methodology and all that, how environmental degradation takes place, what are the causes and all. Can you here we talk about the impact of environmental degradation on society, on tribes, how does it affect tribes and so on. So that will be the difference in terms of the area. Okay, so this area will be focused more in this paper. There is a lot of scope for analysis here and you will get essays also from here. Now coming to these two, as you all know, the best part is this came into existence only on, for whatever you have to cover only for these 6 to 7 years. There will be a lot of emphasis on the development that took place in these 6 to 7 years. The most important source will be the socio-economic survey. And you have to mug up the facts. Inevitably, there will be more focus on and development by the government. Okay, now moving on, Indian economy, here this is all more about facts, but all your concepts will come here. But as far as my understanding of the current exam dynamics is concerned, I don't look at them asking you concepts. It will be more from Atmanirbhar Bharat is a sure shot question in your economy. So it will be more from current perspective that they'll ask. So here the concerned teacher will ensure that the current part is more covered. And I'll ensure that the socio-economic survey is done in the class in detail. Because without that, getting marks in this is impossible. Okay? Done. The fifth paper, if you ask me, the most challenging paper itself is because of the first 100 marks. And I have decided to allot more number of hours for S&T because S&T is totally new for you. In group 2, you must have studied only the current based science and technology. Conceptual part has to be explained. So we will have more time allotted to the first two segments of paper 5 and
The third segment would not be a problem. See, basically both are S&T. S&T, biotechnology, space technology, everything is covered. Space, all this is covered. Here, one essay that I expect from my perspective, one essay topic inevitably will be artificial intelligence and its applications is very, very important. Like this, we are going to identify. You know, this is one topic. I will give another topic, that is India's journey in space technology. India, its achievements and challenges, because there is a lot of emphasis on space by the government. So like this, the teacher will first teach you the concept, then he will come to the essays. There will be nearly 4 or 5 essays that you are going to write only on science and technology. And because my choice that kundu S&T way chunte, you should really be very well versed with this. This part is one, and the second part is data interpretation is majorly to be practiced. Mental ability and logical reasoning is also there. I think difference in content, in group 2 lo, you just solve and identify. Can you group 1 kocche sir, kyan problem osu ante? In group 1, you have to write the steps. It is like you remember in school we used to write the steps. The same approach should be there here. Okay, and this will be practiced. Sir has told me that he will require 30 to 35 hours to comprehensively cover this part. And a practice Japistan. Okay. Finished? Now moving on to the last part, our paper 6. Paper 6, as you all know, is formation. It was 150 marks in your group 2. Here also it is 150 marks. But here what I am going to do is, here we will require more of analysis, you know. Paper 6, I handle myself. It is, but this will be more from analytical point of view. See, meeraina evaraina, we have to read Prakash, but apart from Prakash, I have read almost all the books that were written on formation of Telangana. What I've done is I have identified 2 types of questions. In fact, when we talk about the types of questions, please listen to this carefully. What kind of questions will you get in your exam? Usually we think that since it is the State Public Service Commission exam, most of the questions will be direct. Direct ante, we are asking about what, where, okay, how, processes, how is the constitutional amendment done, okay, what, where, how, and when, who, itlanti questions meeda ekku emphasis unde. Kani, there is another set of questions which we call as indirect, which is usually called as. Here, even in group 2, in the objective questions, we ensured that we had a mix of both. Okay, ibi indirect leda, we call them as statement quote based questions. Ikkada, you'll need a lot of analysis along with facts. Okay, compare and contrast. Okay, comment, elucidate, itlanti questions anni statement, and they'll simply give a statement. See, you know, one of the books I read that the Million March was the watershed moment in the third phase of the Telangana agitation. This can be asked as a 10 marker. What led to the Millennium March? What happened during the march? What were the implications of the March? Atla, we have to identify some statement based questions and we have to write. From my perspective, it should be a mix of both direct and statement based. I have told all the teachers, including I'm also going to do the same thing. We are going to first start with, because you know this will give you confidence. It is easy diagram. Mere the first raaste, tarvaat statement based questions diagram chal easy hai. So we are going to first start with direct questions. Be it polity, be it Telangana. Telangana movement anukondi. What are the causes of the 1969 agitation? Okay, direct and indirect causes. A simple question. Then when I ask you to compare 1969 flaws emunde, how they were these flaws rectified in the last phase of the agitation ane sarki, you have to have an analysis in mind. You have to know the entire movement in order to understand the flaws of the 1969 agitation. So what we are going to do is, we are going to first start with direct questions in every subject, then we are going to move on to statement based questions. But it's going to be a mix of both of these. It is syllabus overview. Any questions that you would like to ask me? Coming to material and books, meekunna time ki meer already group 2 ki prepare ayi unnaru kabatti meer chaala books chaduvuntaru. మీకున్న టైంకి ఇప్పుడు మళ్ళీ కొత్తగా అవన్నీ బుక్స్ తీసి చదవడం చాలా కష్టం. నన్ను అడుగుతా అయితే సినాప్సిస్ ఉంటే బెటర్, లేదా రిలై ఆన్ వాట్ వీఆర్ గివింగ్ అండ్ జస్ట్ రీడ్ ఇట్, దట్ ఈస్ మోర్ దెన్ ఎనఫ్. కాకపోతే మీరు అది చదవడం ఎక్కువైతుంది. అంతేనా విద్య? See, for someone who hasn't prepared for groups at all, this batch I would not recommend. Because you know it is very difficult. Somebody who is prepared for civils is also okay. They can cope up. Because you know 50 hours. Maamul kehte we teach for 8 months here. Group 1 is for 8 months. Completing it in 50 days is impossible for a fresher. So you know this batch would be only for employees or people who have nearly missed group 2 or who have prepared and written civils mains. They can cope up with this batch. Okay. Any more questions? For you all, you have to look at the full-time batches, regular batches. Abhi pan ke raho. Yes? So this is the overview. The other details we will be giving you all shortly. And the date, time, 50 days main chepina kada, I'll just send the sheet around. Have a look at it, and if you have any suggestions, let me know. Thank you.